there's also here with fuzz, and if you held it up to the light, you can see a bunch of tiny little dots all along the edge. This is called your selvage edge. When you are cutting fabric, you take selvage edge to selvage edge. So just recently, most of you have cut out four squares for a seam sample. You fold your fabric so you get two pieces. Generally, when you have a pattern, it will always say how many you should cut. This pattern says cut two. So I fold my fabric so I get two of these pieces. Selvage edges are together. That way I know that the greatest stretch is going this way, not this way. There's some stretch, but my greatest stretch is this way. You can't see this now, but this is the bum area. This is the whole leg. I don't need stretch this way. I need stretch this way. So when they sit down and all of our bums grow, as you sit, greatest stretch goes across. Folded selvage edge to selvage edge. I put it down so I am using what's called economy of fabric. This still is left. So if somebody wants to use a chunk, if I open this up, it's actually this much fabric left. So economy of fabric is always on your mind. Now I notice that that is cut a bit, and so I need to move over a tiny bit, but for most part, I'm being pretty cheap on my fabric usage. When you're pinning a pattern, to make sure that your pattern is straight on grain, is you pin what's called the grain line. So I pin my arrowhead, one of the top ones. Then I take my measuring tape, and all will be expected to do this. I go to my selvage edge and it's 42. Then I come all the way down and I pin again and I nailed it. Sometimes people's patterns are like this. If it's off, you can almost see that it's crooked, but to make sure it's perfectly straight so you don't get shifting of a seam. Sometimes our pair of pants are like this. I'm sure some of you have felt that before, or a shirt. It's because they haven't paid attention to straight a grain. So we measure, it should be 42. If it's not, we adjust. I then pin my arrowhead. Then I pin my corners. So I won't go everywhere, but I pin corners, corners, corners. And now what I do is I take my pins and I pin so close to the edge so that when my scissors come close to it, it is laying flat. Here's what I see that is incorrect. I see this. What's wrong with that? When I go to cut, my scissors are going to hit it. So again, close to the edge. Before you cut, your job is to call me over.